Hey, it's me, Miyori Roshi, and today I bring you some more Heroes of the Storm. It's going to be a guide about Zeratul, the melee assassin, as you can see here in the top. And I call this guide the Snipe-atul guide, because you're going to be able to snipe down people really fast. Tanks in a double rotation, and anything else in a tank in a single rotation. Let's get into it. The easiest way to show you is by going to the play button and then the hero information. Here you can see, first of all, his basic abilities. Let's talk about them first. Cleave is his bread and butter skill. He damages nearby enemies in a 360 degrees around him. Then his second ability is Singularity Spike. It basically is a sticky bomb. You throw it at your opponent. It sticks on him for 1 second, then it will deal damage and slow the target for 1 second. His third skill is Blink, and this is just an amazing utility skill. You can use it in so many ways. You can, for example, blink out of sticky situations, you can blink in front of people to body block them, you can hunt those pesky avatars in their base by just blinking over the walls, and then after you kill them, blink out. It is just an amazing ability. The blink plays are being enabled though by the permanent cloak passive of Zeratul. He becomes invisible while not attacking or taking damage for 2 seconds. Invisible is not the right word though, because if you are an old StarCraft player or a new StarCraft 2 player, then you will notice that all the cloaked units in StarCraft just leave this little shimmer on the screen. It's like a distortion that you can see, you can detect it, and this also counts for Zeratul. And Nova is another champion that has cloak, for example, that you can also see by the distortion on the screen. So this means that you, despite being cloaked, need to pay attention about your positioning. You still want to hug bushes and you still want to find ways to get to your opponent that are more unconventional, that just surprise your opponent. Zeratul has two heroic abilities, Void Prison and Shadow Assault. I will not discuss Shadow Assault because it is just a really bad ultimate. It is just inferior in every possible way. Void Prison is the way to go. No matter what, you will always want a Void Prison. Why is this? Void Prison leaves a bubble, and in this bubble anyone gets stuck for 5 seconds. They will not take damage, they will become invulnerable when they're in this bubble, but this can just change entire team fights. If you place a well-placed Void Prison, you can, for example, take out the entire front line of the opponents, and then it's a 3, for example, when they have 2 tanks, 3 versus 5, you just take down in those 5 seconds their backline, and you just win in one go the entire team fight there. It is a double-edged sword though, because you can also get your own team members stuck in the Void Prison, so it requires really, really precision about the placement of your Void Prison. Then let's get into the talents. For the sniper tool, at level 1 I always take Seasoned Marksman, unless I really have the feeling that the opponent is gonna focus me hard. If they will do that, then I'm gonna take Block, for example. It decreases a lot of late game power on Zeratul to be able to snipe down the tanks, for example, but you will still be able to snipe down the squishies without Seasoned Marksman. Seasoned Marksman is a pretty interesting skill. In the beginning it does not give you anything unless you get stacks later on, and these stacks add up over time. Every time you're nearby a hero kill, you get 2 stacks, and every time you're nearby an enemy minion or mercenary kill, you get 1 stack. At 6 stacks you get 1 basic attack damage. And especially in certain maps, this just stacks up so fast. For example, in Haunted Mines or in Garden of Terror, you have all these extra objective minions spawning across the map. And they just give you free stacks for the seasoned marksman. On top of it, I will later take a talent that boosts the attack damage even further. So this is just amazing talent for sniping down people. I see a lot of Zeratuls taking the Greater Cleave. I want to take this opportunity to just say, please, please do not ever take Greater Cleave on Zeratul. It is such a bad talent. If you cannot hit your cleave, even with a blink on top of people, then just stop playing Zeratul. Please do not take this radius of cleave increase, because it does not do anything. It does not give you battle stats, combat stats, it does not give you anything. It's just useless skill, really. Nah, the second talent we take is Gathering Power. This is a bit of a double-edged sword, because Gathering Power does give you passive 8 ability power, and on top it can give you a bonus of 12, so a total of 20% ability power. This is really amazing. Way better than Focus Attack, for example. But the problem is with Gathering Power that if you die, you will lose all your stacks and you have to stack up again, so you will lose temporarily a lot of power. So Focus Attack is the safer route to go, but less powerful. Gathering Power is the more risky route to take, but more powerful for later on. I always take Gathering Power. Then at talent 7, you will take Rending Cleave for the Snipe-atul. It deals additional 50% damage over 5 seconds, and that is your cleave damage. And your cleave damage goes up per level. So this is just a static that will just go up, 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 up. At the end of level 30, it is 585 damage. You get 50% on top as a dot. It is really nice to take down people that just barely survive after your normal attacks. Another skill that you could take is Searing Attacks. It basically, by activating it, you get for 5 seconds long basic attacks extra 50% damage. So together with the Focus Attack, that is 100 extra basic attack damage. Now then, the Void Prison at level 10, do not take Shadow Assault. And at level 13, Assassin's Blade. This increases your attack damage after decloaking. So with the seasoned marksman combined, you get 25% extra attack damage on top, and at level 30 again, you will just deal around, yeah, you deal the same attack damage as your cleave, and that is with not even that many stacks. You will just deal so much auto attack damage. You will just blink in front of someone and just auto attack him down. And last but not least, for the talents, Double Bomb for the Snipe-atul build. You can cast Singularity Spike twice. You can just stack these on each other. They literally just stack on each other and then boom boom, deal double damage, and they will slow them for once. That is the downside of having double bombs quick after each other. But it has an amazing burst, because yeah, you just do double damage in one go, and then on top the cleave damage and one auto attack damage most of the time, as squishy as that. And at level 20, you have two options to take. You can take Protective Prison, so that your allies will not get caught in the Void Prison. I prefer myself Bolt of the Storm. It is an extra blink on top of your normal blink, so they will just never catch you after this. If you get this one, you can just blink over double walls. They will just never catch you as soon as you have this thing. It is really handy to take Bolt of the Storm, and this is my way to go. If you place your Void Prisons good, and if you don't screw it up too much, then you will not hit your allies anyway, and yeah, this is then becoming useless. Okay, then I want to show you a replay of me playing the Snipe-atul. Have fun watching. Okay, so there we are in the loading screen for Haunted Mines. Every now and then the underground mines will open and you will get the possibility to kill some undead, and these undead drop skulls. The more skulls you gather, the bigger your golem will be that will spawn afterwards. I'm following myself because this is a guide about Zeratul, the Spike-atul. And as you can see here in the chat, I said that indeed if the enemy team is not a tanky, I can hunt them down pretty easy. Enemy has an avatar, it's always interesting. When you're a cloak character, you kind of want to hunt him down because he is so easy to kill. Avatar wastes immediately all his mines. And there's a fight now for the vision. Nazebo nicely blocked the cleave. The hook, I mean, from Stitches with his wall of zombies. And behind us, we have a Vella capturing. She's pretty ballsy. She just goes there solo. And another hook missed. Meanwhile, Murky dies, but yeah, it's Murky. He does die all the time. It does not matter. Nah, we got first blood. And there we capture back our vision. Immediately going for the next. Took season's marksman. I cannot see how much tags I have. Still needs to be added a lot of stuff here in the replay. But you can already see that I killed two opponents, so I at least got four stacks already. Now, here's an entire wave almost, so I already have two or three stacks right now of extra attack damage. That's in the first minute. Heroes slay. The mines will open shortly. A bit of harass on the fella. And now I have to get ready for the mine, so that's why I'm quickly gonna take this shrine to get my mana up to the max. I'm running to the bottom. Oh, my bad. Because that's where my team is, so we kinda want to enter with the entire team in one go. A really nice hook here. Try to take him down to give us an immediate advantage, because if he would be dead, then it would have been an easy 4 versus 5 in the mines for us. And this is the minions I talked about during the intro. You get stacks from these as well, but just killing them. Well, 3 stacks, hop a day. Nah, Vala is really ballsy again. Just dies 1v4. Then the Zeebo is over here. He's also getting caught. This is where I body block him. A really nice save from the avatar. We're giving him the shield, but he died anyway because he teleported out. Then we teleported after him and then he teleported back in, and just Vala was waiting there together with Lily. We already have 59 skulls. We already have more than half, so everything that we get now is just a bonus. Vala is really ballsy. Constantly thinks he can just take on his own 5 people or 4. Not the brightest. After you take all the skulls that you can, you most of the time rush immediately mid because your enemy team will want to counter your big golem with the knight's camp. That's where we're going now. Vella already started it. She took a little bit of damage because of that. And her nice hook of Stitches. She won't survive that. I blink after her. Get trapped, but it's not enough to stop me from killing that Vella. I do get slowed here, but as you can see, just try to go as fast for those stags again. Just clear those waves. to kill here the enemy golem as fast as possible. Together with the help of Lily and Vella, it shouldn't be too hard. Enemies have it way harder. No, you should have just saw Murky respawning there, and a bit of lag. He has placed his egg here, so every time he dies, as long as his egg is alive, he will just jump back. Place a bit further back now for the next golem that might actually destroy it immediately. No, I'm gonna get the vision back again, I think. No, I'm actually looking for the avatar right now. Where is he? I did get my level 8 talent, or level 7 it was, I think. So I now have like rending cleave as well. So that means that I can easily take down Avatar on my own. Nah, I couldn't find him. So that's why I take the vision back. Meanwhile, there's a battle going on in the top. I think I can snipe down the Vella. That's what I'm going for. Up. Blink after her and kill her with an auto attack. I do think that the rending cleave would have taken her. I did not necessarily have to blink after her. Still checking for the avatar, where he is. And here I blink over the wall, check where he is. Luckily Vella misses me. Like I said, you can see the distortion, so but most of the time people don't expect you to be here. Especially not this avatar, as you will see. Up. There we go. And since you have your blink back up, you can just blink over the wall and get away. Fight was going on top, so you don't have to fear anything that you get killed. No, back up to full health. And there we go again to assist our team. Or to actually push to the top lane to get more attack damage stacks. Oh yeah, that's what. I saw that the fort was really low, so I thought, hey, I can take this one down before the mines. And then I see Nazebo, and that kind of scares me, because I do not know where the enemy is. I see them in the bot lane, but I prefer to just already go into the mine and not die to get all the skulls.
Within the mines, shall you brave the darkness?
And again, these free stacks, so nice. Haunted Mines is definitely the best map for this build, and yeah, after that, Garden of Terror, I think. I do remember around this time I had about 25 stacks already. Extra attack damage. Hero slain. Hero slain. The enemy team is dying. And our Murky is of course all the time dying, but it doesn't matter. As long as he still has his egg. Now, we as a team already got 55, while the enemy has nothing. Well, now they get their first. I saw this one was the last one taken, and then I saw the counter go up, I knew that the artist was here. Deal a bit of damage, as soon as he pops his ult, I'm like, okay, that's nice, you wasted your ult there. Then we can just focus him down now. Hop. That's the artist. The rest goes after them, but we want to take the big golem. The heals of Lily, it's pretty easy to just take, yeah, tank it. This is Zeratul.
Rise again.
saw the Vella coming, so I teleported away because I was a bit low. But yeah, she's just getting kills. They're so far behind already now. No, there's a Murkamp catcher and a giant wave here, so I kind of want to get this wave for the stacks again. Plus, yeah, they deal a lot of damage to the fort otherwise, so I kind of want to take that out. Then immediately after the golems, you have to go mid again. Because, as you can see, the enemies will try to capture it. To at least get something out of it. A polymorph there. So I couldn't really go deeper in. That's why I immediately went back. And we're just gonna take down the golem again. I'm not gonna even bother with an Azebo unless a Vella is helping. Yeah, then we can easily take him and focus afterwards the golem. Obatar in the meanwhile has been at his spawn. He got scared after he got dove in there by me. That's what most Obatars do, and this is really beneficial for your team because his locusts will just not do anything. They will just expire before they even reach your gates. As you can see here, the timer. He just walked all the way from the spawn to here. And it's just almost down. I was thinking about going base because I'm low on mana, so I will not be that useful. But because, yeah, off-season marksman, you deal so much auto attack damage. You see that 252 damage to the gate with a cleave 296. It's just insane. After you get the Assassin's Blade passive, every 5 seconds after you come out of stealth, is just your attack damage is so high. You kind of want to, after 5 seconds of auto attack, and you just want to disengage, go in stealth and get that boost again. What you kind of should do every time. For example, against the big golem, after 5 seconds you just walk away a bit and then you just walk back in again with the attack damage boost for 5 seconds. Gonna capture the solo camp. It's really easy to do on Zeratul, especially also if you take the block passive. I'm actually not sure, by the way, if the block passive helps against damage from the mercs. I actually don't think so, so sorry. But with the extra attack damage again, you just auto attack those minions down very fast. You can easily even take the hard camp solo, but yeah, you will go low. That's kind of the thing, so you need to do it sneaky. You need to make sure that people don't see you doing it. They will kill you otherwise. Nah, Nazebo is an easy kill. I don't even have to do much. Just blink on top of him, cleave, throw in Singularity Spike and it's done. Then the mines start again, plus there's a gigantic wave in the top. So that's what I'm going for. Kinda wanna clear that wave because, yeah, first of all stacks. Second of all, this is all gonna get into our fort and it's just a lot of wasted experience then, when we're in the mines. There we go. Already in the mines before they actually spawned. And the first one is taking all these skulls, extra stacks. Here's just one whole attack damage waiting to get taken. Yeah, auto attacks at the moment already deal 355 attack damage. It's just amazing. The cleave dealt 427, I believe, there. Let's check it in the next camp. 457, even. Another lag. Stitches comes to help. And here you'll see that I will walk away, I will wait for my stealth, then I'll go back in to get the attack damage boost. aggro a little bit with stitches. Here again, the stealth. And hop a day and throw double bombs. Stealth again, get the attack damage boost.
Now is the hour of my golem's return.
We got 100 skulls, so this is the end. This is just. At 14 minutes, 100 skulls, golem, when the enemy team is 3 levels behind, it's just the end of the game. Again, we're gonna take the mid. I'm not actually sure if we're gonna take it. I think I soloed it, or. Oh no, it's just helping. I could just solo it though. As you saw there, I have max ability power stacks and the singularity spike deals 552 damage. That is times 2. So you deal 1100 damage just by the double singularity spike. It is a lot of damage. Plop plop, yeah, saw that. It was just one singularity spike and one cleave. That was not even the double singularity spike. Almost died there, but I know we kinda won. It's a 100 skulls golem already bashing at the Nexus at the core. Sorry, League of Legends history is in me, so sometimes make these grammatical mistakes. Now, I hope this guide helped. I hope I will less see Ren. Cleaves that increase radius, and just go snipe some people out there. Thanks for watching, and subscribe if you liked. Bye bye.